We are going to discuss in continuation only gravitation. Gravitation, this is the sixth lecture of this. We are dealing in continuation. And today we have to talk about in detail about the satellite. Of course, you are aware of this word satellite with you. And so many times you have heard this word in the news also. That satellite is there, and that due to that satellite you are getting so much information. Like if nowadays we talk about the China borders and all, they are giving you all the actions or whatever their activities going on the border by the pictures from the satellite. So what is satellite? First question with us is, what is satellite? Of course, if I talk about in the universe, the heavenly body which is moving around the planet. Because solar system, you all know, and we have discussed that Earth is revolving around the sun. If I talk about the Earth, it is revolving around the sun, and your moon is revolving around the Earth. So I can say that Earth is a satellite of Sun and Moon is a satellite of Earth. So any object which is revolving around any other heavenly body, that is termed as its satellite. So all the planets can be taken as the satellites of the Sun. And when I talk about on Earth, staying on Earth, our main focus will be, of course, working on Earth only. So when I talk about our Earth, then I can talk about two type of satellites with me. One is the natural satellites, which is by nature it is there. Like Moon is the natural satellite of Earth. And second with you is artificial satellite. It means man-made satellites. So when I talk about man-made satellites, I am putting them in different orbits. Like if this circle I have taken for the Earth, then of course this is not actually the circle we have discussed. It is ellipse in shape. So this plane which is passing through its equatorial axis, that is equatorial plane. If I make any object to move in this orbit, in the equatorial orbit, then and it is made to move in the same direction of the rotation of Earth, then what happens? It appears stationary to us and termed as geostationary satellite. And the second with you is, which is revolving in the polar orbit, that is termed as polar satellite. So what is the principle, or how we can launch a satellite, how we are making the satellite to move around the Earth? That is important. You can be asked, because the direct question also can be there for the principle of launching of a satellite, how we have decided. As you have seen even in movies also, we are making this satellites and we are putting them in different orbits. So we are going in detail of this launching of a satellite. Of course, your previous knowledge is important. If I'm talking about the projectile motion in the previous knowledge, if you have seen that if I make a body to throw from a height, if I'm making it a body to throw from a height, I give it some horizontal velocity, then what happens? It comes to the ground, it covers some horizontal range. If I increase this horizontal velocity, then its horizontal range is getting increased. So this is to be kept in mind when we have to talk about the principle of launching of a satellite. Then here's, we are making two things are required. One, of course, I have to give a velocity, minimum velocity, which is required to escape from the Earth orbit. And the second is, to give it such a horizontal velocity so that it's not coming on the Earth back, rather it starts revolving around the Earth in a fixed orbit. And that is, of course, is a very tedious work. You have to decide about the velocity, what is to be given, because now so many satellites, like in India, we are using the INSAT series. Similarly, different countries, they are putting different satellites in the different orbits. So you have to see which orbit you want to send your satellite and what type of information you want to get from that satellite. Like for communication also, we are using geostationary satellites. For weather forecasting, polar satellites are being used. So where we want to fix up or put our satellite, in which particular orbit, there can be different orbits can be made. Of course, if I go with the particular shape, then of course it is an elliptical shape. But to make our mathematics easy, we take the shape to be circular of the Earth, and similarly this orbit we also consider as to be circular. This is one thing which is limitation with us. You have to keep that while doing all the derivations, we are considering it to be path to be circular. So it means two things are there. One is minimum vertical velocity, which is termed as the escape velocity, which is to be given to a satellite to reach up to a particular height. Firstly, we are making them to reach a particular height, and from that height we are giving the horizontal velocity. That horizontal velocity we are calling it as the orbital velocity. So it means two things. One is escape velocity is to be given. Second is orbital velocity is to be given. And of course, escape velocity, if we talk about of Earth, then it is 11.2 km per second, and we cannot impart such a velocity in a single go. So we are using multi-stage rockets, three stage, five stages are being used to give a particular velocity, so that your satellite is launch vehicles. You must have heard the names. Launch vehicles are used to give a particular height, and different stages the velocity it is getting increased, and when it reaches at this particular velocity, then we give a required horizontal velocity so that it is able to move in that whatever is our required orbit, that is your satellite orbit. So this is important. Multi-stage rockets are being used to give the escape velocity, and then that particular horizontal velocity, which is termed as the orbital velocity. So we have to go in detail of both these velocities. One is escape velocity, another is orbital velocity. So of course we will go one by one. First with you is escape velocity. Escape velocity, of course we have to find its derivation, also expression for it. And we will be looking for the escape velocity from the Earth, of course. So firstly, let us define escape velocity, which is the minimum velocity with which a body must be projected vertically upwards, or we can say it should be in a direction of movement of the Earth, in which direction the Earth is rotating, so as to help it to escape. So we have to give that particular minimum velocity so that it is just able to escape from the gravitational field of Earth, so that it is not falling back on the Earth. This is one thing we have to take it into consideration, that we have to give minimum velocity with which, when we project the body, it is simply moving out of the Earth's orbit or Earth's gravitational field. So we have to derive the expression for it. So now we are on the surface of Earth. Here we are on the surface of Earth. I want to move it away from the Earth's gravitational field, this direction. So I'm able to move it in this direction, yours, upwards, like in this direction I want to move it. So what it is done? Go away from the surface of Earth. So if I'm supposing my satellite mass is small m, of course Earth mass I have taken as capital M, capital R is the radius of the Earth. These all suppositions which you are supposed to mention in the beginning. I'm initially say at point P, which is at distance x from the center of Earth. So if I want to write the expression for the gravitational force between this Earth and the satellite whose mass I have supposed small m, then by Newton's law of gravitation, or you can say by universal law of gravitation, this force can be written as gmm upon x square. Now if I want to move this body from p to q, small distance dx, then work done which will be done, work done, that small work done will be there, and that small work done will be given by f dot dx. F dot dx. I'm moving the body, I'm moving upward, displacement is also in the upward direction. So if I take dot product f dot dx, theta will be equals to 0. You can always mention that, that your theta will be equals to 0. Theta will be equals to 0, and that you can calculate the value for you. So here if you wish, you may write that theta it is equals to 0. Because f and dx, they are both are in the same direction. So this you have to note, and then you can write the value of small work done, that is f dx, which is given by gmm x square into dx. Now if I want to move the body from the surface of Earth, this point, to the infinity, then what will be the total work done? Total work done will be taken by doing the integration, and when you do the integration, total work done W will be equals to integral of dW from R to infinity. And dW we have already calculated, that is gmm upon x square into dx. So you can put the value, gmm is constant, can be taken out, x power minus 2 when you take the integration, x power n plus 1 divided by n plus 1, it means x power minus 2 plus 1 divided by minus 2 plus 1, and I'm getting it minus 1 by x integration. And when I put the limits, upper limit minus lower limit, then you can get the value for gmm, that is equals to minus 1 upon infinity plus 1 upon r. So this is the value for the total work done if I want to move the body from the surface of the Earth to infinity. Now, if on the surface of Earth, if I'm supposing that I'm willing to give some velocity v, then what will be the value of kinetic energy which is imparted? Kinetic energy will be equals to half mve square. Now this, according to work energy theorem, this is the key point for this derivation. You have to apply the work energy theorem, that is work done in moving the body from R to infinity is equals to change in the kinetic energy. So initially, this is the velocity I have given, which is giving me the kinetic energy, half mve square, that is equals to gmm upon r. And from here you can calculate the value for ve. Ve square you are getting, because small m on both the sides will get cancelled, I am getting 2gm upon r. So I can write the value of ve equals to square root of 2gm upon r. This is the expression with me when I am willing to move the body from the surface of Earth. This velocity is to be given so that the body can escape from Earth's gravitational field. Now, because I know the relation between small g and capital G, I can write small g it is equals to gm upon r square, or I can take the value of gm from here, that is equals to gm equals to small g r square. So this is r square years, and then if you solve it, you will be able to get the value for ve, which is equals to square root of gr. This is the second way of writing the same formula for the escape velocity. of course, if I put the value here for small g 9.8 and radius of the arc 6400 kilometer or 6.4 in 10 to the power 6 meter, then I will be getting it equals to 11.2 kilometer per second for the earth. At the same time, bachche, you can see that this escape velocity is independent of the mass of the satellite. So it does not depend upon the mass of the satellite, but it depends upon the mass of the planet around which you want to make the body to revolve. So it means it depends upon the mass of Earth, if I am talking about the satellites of Earth. If I want to talk about satellite of Jupiter or Moon or any heavenly body, then it will depend upon the mass of that heavenly body around which I want to make the body to revolve. So I can, this is the third way of writing the same formula. I can take the value of the mass of the Earth, which is equals to, because we are assuming the this is to be as a sphere having capital R as the radius. So I can replace mass by volume into density, uniform density we are taking rho. Then M can be written as 4 by 3 pi R cube rho. And when you put this value of M here in this first formula with you, then I'm getting it equals to 8 pi rho g R square divided by. So this is the third way of writing the formula for the escape velocity, which is dependent upon the density and the gravitational constant. It means now I'm not writing in terms of the acceleration due to gravity. So this is important with you, because we can use these formulas for solving the numericals directly. At the same time, you should be knowing that for finding this escape velocity, we have ignored the actual shape of the earth, as well as we are ignoring the air resistance. Air resistance also, because otherwise is going to affect your escape velocity. So escape velocity has to be actually little greater than 11.2 kilometer per second for earth if I talk. And for the heavenly bodies for which your RMS speed is greater than the escape velocity, then atmosphere will not be able to stay. Like on Moon, we say there is no atmosphere. So that we have to see that escape velocity for different heavenly bodies are different. This is very important derivation with you for finding the escape velocity. Another velocity which is to be given after making it, after making the body to escape from the Earth's gravitational pull, that is the orbital velocity, which is the horizontal velocity which is required to put the satellite into an orbit around the Earth. So this is the definition for the orbital velocity. It is the velocity which is required to put the satellite in its orbit around the Earth. And of course, for different orbits, orbital velocity has to be different. Where you want to put, at what distance you want to put, I mean. Again, my suppositions you have to write in the beginning. We are assuming Earth to be sphere again, uniform density rho. R, capital R, is taken as the radius of the Earth. I'm assuming the body, it means the satellite of mass small m, to be at distance small r from the center of Earth. From the center of Earth, the distance is small r. If I take height h is there above the surface of Earth, then small r can be written as capital R plus h. And now if I want to write the gravitational force using Newton's law of gravitation between the Earth and the satellite, this small m is satellite years, then this I can write by using the Newton's law of gravitation, that is gmm upon r square, because small r is the distance between them. So I will be writing it as gravitational force equals to gmm upon small r square. Now, if I want the satellite to move in the circular orbit, then I know I have to give the centripetal forces required to keep the body in the circular orbit. And if I'm saying that I'm giving VO as the velocity to it, then the centripetal force which is there, that will be given by mv naught square upon r. This is again the formula you are aware of. Now, if this centripetal force which is required is always given by the gravitational force only, so in case of equilibrium, you have to equate mv naught square upon r, it is a small r of course, it is equals to gmm upon small r square, but small r can be written as capital R plus h. So you may write this expression as mv naught square upon capital R plus h, which is equals to gmm upon r plus h whole square. So now you can solve it, simple mathematics, and you can get equation, but you can write for orbital velocity, it is equals to square root of gm upon r plus h. Velocity, when I'm talking about I have to move a body from a height. Escape velocity is to be taken from the surface of earth I'm giving. And when I'm talking about the orbital velocity I'm here at a height I'm there, that is to be noted. So but if I want, I can apply the things under conditions only. In limited conditions I can say that your g, small g, it is equals to gm upon r square, and then I can write v naught, that is equals to r square root of g plus g divided by r plus h. This is the formula only, but see, small g at a given place we don't find, we are most of the times talking at the surface of earth, and this is again not the actual situation because h is not equals to 0 actually, but to just get the limited value of the thing, we are writing it in this way that v naught I'm replacing, I'm keeping h equals to 0, I'm getting the minimum value for the orbital velocity, which is coming out to be 7.9 into 10 raised to the power 3 meter per second. So 7900, it means nearly 8000 you can say. And if I want to compare the orbital velocity and escape velocity, this is I'm getting escape velocity is root 2 times the orbital velocity, only for theoretical purpose, which is not true for the practical things, because you have seen for orbital velocity I have to give from a height, while escape velocity is to be given from the surface of earth. And when I'm talking about the orbital velocity, the points which are to be noted, of course it is independent of the mass of the satellite. Second point is that it is decreasing with the increase in the radius. That is, when I'm increasing the height, then because you can see it is orbital velocity is inversely proportional to small r. So you can say that it is decreasing with the increase in radius, or I can say with the increase in height. Of course, it also depends upon the mass and radius of the planet about which you are making the body to revolve. Because if you are willing to revolve around Jupiter or Saturn or any other planet, then it will depend upon the mass and radius of that planet. So these are the points. Of course, all the time we are, when escape velocity we are talking, we are not talking about the air resistance. We are assuming the orbits to be circular just to solve the things, means to apply the mathematics more easily with you. So keep things up to this for today. Thank you, everyone.